Hello, I'm Elena Zamagni. I'm working as an hematologist at the Bologna University School of Medicine. So my role today is to speak a little bit around the topic of imaging in plasma cell dyscrasia and multiple myeloma. So what are the current recommendations from the International Myeloma Working Group? So for sure, regarding the staging of the disease, both in the early stages, so smoldering myeloma and also active myeloma, the minimum requirement nowadays is whole body low dose CT. So we are all recommended to perform this to confirm or exclude the presence of lytic lesions that are one of the criteria to start a new treatment. So this is true both for newly diagnosed patient, but also in each phase of the disease when relapse occurs. And this is true also for smoldering, because if we are finding lytic lesion, those patients are not smoldering anymore, but they are active myeloma. So what to do differently? MRI is recommended if there is something clinical that is pushing to do this exam, but is technically not strictly required, as well as PET-CT is recommended if there is a clinical or some other doubt of extramedullary disease, because it is the most sensitive technique. So in these two cases, you may add to whole body low dose CT these two other techniques. And in smoldering myeloma, a whole body MRI is also recommended, because if you have a negative CT, but you have more than one focal lesion at MRI, you may go for a treatment. So even if the low dose CT is negative and you're finding something at the MRI, what you have to do is different. Regarding the evaluation of response to therapy, the currently recommended technique is FDG PET-CT, because it's the technique that demonstrated in independent prospective clinical trials a prognostic relevance, and that demonstrated also to have a meaning in the context of a CR patient. So acting as a sort of minimal residual disease outside the bone marrow requirement. So PET-CT with FDG is the gold standard, but of course is not a perfect technique like each technique. So it may have some pitfalls, for example, some false negative patient. So in this case, when the PET-CT is false negative or negative at baseline, PET-CT with FDG is not recommended, and you may either do nothing or go for a different technique, so PET-CT with another tracer or MRI with the diffusion-weighted imaging protocol. These two last tools are less standardized, are less routinely used, and there are less clinical data, but for sure they will grow in the future, so they would be a good alternative. If the PET-CT is negative after therapy, you stop like that. So you are not doing any other imaging technique until the relapse occurs. If PET-CT is doubt or there is some positivity, it is recommended to perform another PET-CT after 6-12 months, or to alternate PET-CT with MRI. So this is what we have in our hands now. And I can say that these novel imaging techniques are on the way or completely standardized nowadays, because we have several recommendation papers on how to perform them, how to interpret, how to evaluate. So there is some help for clinicians on this, but some work is still ongoing. So for sure, it's not completely ended up. And maybe finally, we can make a comment about MGUS. In low and standard risk MGUS, there is no current recommendation for an imaging. In high risk MGUS, you may consider to go for whole body low dose CT. So whole body X-ray remains only in countries or situation when really you cannot go for anything else. If you really don't have any alternatives, you may consider what was previously the standard of care, but is not the standard of care anymore.